Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi
Assalamualaikum
wabarakatuh. Hello everyone. My name is Natasha Arsi Prameswari from Perbanas Institute Jakarta, International Class Program Accounting 2018 with student number 1811000109.
And hello everyone, my name is Nur Haliza from Perbanas Institute Jakarta, International Class Program Accounting 2018 with student number 1811000159.
In this video, we will invite you guys to learn with us about ratio analysis and company prospective analysis. In here, we will analyze PT Indofood CBP financial statement.
And also, this video aims to fulfill a financial report analysis assignment to our lecturer, Mr. Riza Mawardi, SEMA.
In here, we want to analyze about financial report of PT Indofood CBP. Before that, let's get to know a brief description about this company. PT Indofood CBP Sukser Makmur TBK or ICBP is engaged in the manufacturing of noodles and food ingredients, culinary food products, biscuits, snacks, nutrition and specialty foods, packaging, trading, transportation, warehousing and cold storage, management services, and research and development.
ICBP originated from the consumer branded product CBP Group of its parent company, PT Indofood Sukses Makmur TBK. PT Indofood Sukses Makmur TBK, its business operation began in 1982 with the production of instant noodles. CBP Group entered into nutrition and special food in 1985, and in 1990 expanded into snack food through a corporation with the Frotelein Nederson Holding BV and affiliated company of PepsiCo. The food seasoning business was set up in 1991. The dairy business began in 2008 through the acquisition of Drayton PTA LTD, the majority shareholder of PT Indolacto. In 2009, Indofood restructured the various consumer business under CBP Group to establish ICBP. Since its establishment as a separate entity, ICBP has developed its business and strengthened its leading position in the most of its market segment.
So in here is the financial statement of PT Indofood CBP, and also in here is for year 2019, also 2020. And in here is a statement of profit or loss and other comprehensive income of the company. After this, the ratio analysis will be presented by my friend Nur Haliza.
Thank you, Natasha. And now I will present about the ratio analysis. Ratio analysis is a quantitative method of gaining insight into a company liquidity, operational efficiency, and profitability by studying its financial statement, such as the balance sheet and income statement. Ratio analysis, a cornerstone, a fundamental equity analysis. And the ratio analysis consists of the liquidity ratio. Liquidity ratio is a ratio used to determine the company ability to carry out short-term liabilities that must be fulfilled immediately. This is the calculation of the liquidity ratio. First is a current ratio. Current ratio is a measure the company ability to pay short-term liabilities or debts that are due with the available current asset. The calculation current ratio formula is the total current asset divided by the total current liabilities. The result is 2.26. 2.26, it means the PT Indofood able to manage their current asset and able to pay their short-term liabilities. Every short-term liabilities, 1 rupiah, is guaranteed by 2.26 rupiah. Next is the quick ratio. Quick ratio means measure the company ability to pay liabilities or current debts with the current asset without taking into account the value of the inventory. The quick ratio formula is cash and cash equivalent plus marketable securities plus account receivable divided by total current liabilities. The result of a quick ratio is 1.61. It means the PT Indofood able to manage the liquid asset and able to pay the short-term liabilities reach 1.61 times using the company liquid asset. And next, collection period. Collection period is a measurement that shows how much time it takes for a company to realize its credit sales. The formula collection period is an average account receivable divided by sales divided 360 days. The result of a collection period is around 36 days. 36 days means PT Indofood have a longer days for a collected day account receivable. But my opinion, the days too longer. And PT Indofood must to look at the standard operational to due date for the customer. And next, days to sell inventories. Days to sell inventories means a financial measure of a company performance that give inventory an idea how long it will take the company to convert the inventory into sales. The sales inventory formula is average inventory divided by cost of sales divided 360 days. The result is around 52 days to sell inventory. 52 days means the PT Indofood need take average of around 52 days to purchase, sales, and replace the inventory. And next, the presentation will be present by my partners, Natasha.
Okay, thank you, Liza. So right now, let's talk about the statement of cash flow of PT Indofood CBP. So what is statement of cash flow? Statement of cash flow is the financial statement of a business entity that are used to show the company's cash inflows and outflows during an accounting period. Also, this report is responsible for cash flow during the reporting period. So, the sources and uses of cash flows are, the first one is cash flow from operating activities. The second one is cash flow from investing activities. And the last one is cash flow from financing activities. And so where do the cash flow come from? The first one is net income, and then decrease in assets, and then increase in liabilities, also termination and other non-cash expenses, and the last one is sale of shares. So here we want to talk about cash flow from operating activities. Okay, let's see the net profit. The company was able to generate a net profit of 14.4 billion in 2019. While in 2020, the company was able to earn profit of 17.2 billion. So, these are the statement of cash flow from operating activities. The company's operating cash flow generates a very large amount of positive value. In 2019 is 7.4 million and in 2020 is 9.4 million. Positive cash flow from operating activities means that the company has money left over for non-operating expenses. And here is analysis cash flow from investing activities. The investment cash flow in the company is negative. The amount in 2019 is minus 2.4 million. And in 2020 is minus 35.9 million. The negative investment cash flow value describes the company spending money on investment which will have an impact on future business improvements. And the last one is analysis cash flow from financing activities. Positive cash flow of financing at PT Indofood CBP means that the company receives external funding such as loans or capital deposits to finance its business development. The amount in 2019 is 8.3 million and in 2020 is 9.5 million. Positive funding cash flow can be used to purchase new assets for companies that have the potential to increase the productivity of business that are struggling with revenue growth.
Okay, guys, this is the last session for our to present about the PT Indofood. We want to say thank you so much for your attention. And
also, we are very sorry if there's still a mistake in our calculation. Hope you guys can learn together with us about ratio analysis and company perspective analysis.
So, stay healthy everyone and see you in the next video.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.